In general, we want to use the pooled variance since it corrects for the different sample sizes. In the problem set, you'll get more practice using the pooled variance. But the way the t-statistic is calculated is essentially the same. We divide the observed difference between the mean of x and the mean of y by the standard error, which is calculated slightly differently, where these guys here are this pooled variance. Note that this is the t-statistic when we expect that the true populations that these samples come from are the same. In other words, that the difference between the population parameters is zero. But say we expect that the difference is equal to 10, for example. Then here, we would subtract this expected difference from the observed difference. And this observed difference is what we get from our sample. So this is our full t-statistic for independent samples. But in general in this class, our null hypothesis has been that there's no significant difference between the two populations. In other words, we expect that the difference between the parameters is about zero. There are a few assumptions to keep in mind when using the pooled variance, as there are with any method of measurement. First of all, x and y should be random samples from two independent populations. Remember when we looked at dependent samples? Data coming from the same subject twice? In this case, the populations should be independent. The second is that the populations that x and y come from should be approximately normal. This is less important when the sample sizes are very large, greater than 30. A third assumption is that the sample data can be used to estimate the population variances. And finally, the population variances should be roughly equal, allowing us to use this pooled variance as an estimate of both.